Writing is one of those things that can be super frustrating for teachers and homeschooling families to work on with their students. You with me? Mm-hmm. Today, we're going to look at the many ways we can use Google Slides to get our students writing and even enjoying it. If we haven't met yet, I'm Melissa, homeschooling mom of four and online teacher. Today, we're going to dive into a topic that can be used in classrooms, but also in homeschools. Some of our top worries as homeschoolers are our curriculum, our teaching ability, and the cost associated with educating our kids at home. What I'm going to share today checks all three of those boxes. I want you to rest easy that I've used this in my own homeschool with my kids as they work on writing in both Spanish and English. Stick around to the end. I'm going to share a free download you can use to start teaching writing today. Before we get to the tech, if you're interested in that, check out the timestamps below and you can skip ahead. I just want to address some of the ways that we can go about teaching writing to our own kids at home or in a classroom setting. Remember, if you're working with littles, writing needs to start small. There are some things that we take for granted, but we shouldn't. We really need to teach them. Capitalization, punctuation, and spacing. Usually kids start to get the hang of this in kindergarten and first grade. This is one of those novelty pieces that might motivate your student to write if they're reluctant to use pencil and paper. But hear me when I say pencil and paper writing is awesome and necessary. So if any of these resources that I share today are triggering to you because they're based on tech, make sure you print them. That's totally an option. If your student is ready to type, make sure you walk them through the basics of capitalization, punctuation, spacing, deleting on the computer. This will save you a lot of frustration later on when students are maybe wondering, how do I get here? Why is my cursor there? One way that I've found to do this that's a little bit less daunting is if I open up the Google Doc that my student is going to be using, and then I hop on another computer and open the same Google Doc. We can both edit at the same time. This way, I'm not breathing down their neck. There's no need for me to be standing behind them. Don't you hate that when people do that? They're right next to you when you're working on the computer. And you're able to point them, nudge them toward the place where they need to revise and edit just with a mouse, just with a cursor, instead of pointing and kind of having that clunky conversation just standing behind them. After they get the basics, then work up in volume. Writing is a bit like running. Now, bear with me, those of you who are non-runners. We need to build up stamina as writers and avoid frustration when those mistakes happen, and they will happen. Keeping this process low stress is key for success here. So let's go ahead and pop over to Google Slides so I can show you a bit more. We're going to start by opening up a new Google Slides presentation. I like to let my kids name it something fun, perhaps, but we're going to keep it nice and basic today. My writing journal. By giving them that ownership, it just keeps the novelty there. It's kind of fun. Next, we're going to choose the layout. As this is a writing journal, we're going to go to layout and choose title and body. That way, we've got this nice box up here where we, as the teacher or parent, can add in the writing prompt, and then below it, that's where your student is going to type. I like to label them with days, day one, day two. You might use the date, but we can then add in our prompt. Tell me about your favorite pair of socks. Now, you might need to, depending on your student, add in certain parameters, for example, 3 to 5 sentences. And then we can just resize to make it fit nicely. All right, and you can also change fonts. We want to keep it nice and simple. There we go. And then down here we can change fonts if we'd like, change size if we'd like, your choice. But that's pretty much it. Then you would just duplicate and continue on. Change this to day two and add in a new prompt. With the mention of fonts, a lot of times our students might get a little creative with their writing. I like to make sure they know that they are welcome to change the font, color, size, and type, but only after I have checked their work. That's kind of their reward for getting it done. Otherwise, it can get a little crazy. Now, I hear you, but Melissa, my kids like to click everything. What happens if they delete something or they change something that they shouldn't have in the presentation? Glad you asked. And here's a way to level up if you'd like. And if you'd like to skip this step, I should mention that I've already created 45-day writing hacks in both English and Spanish. You can get them in my store in PowerPoint or Google Slides formats. And if you're a Teachers Pay Teachers person, you can snag them on there too. My store is Melissa is Teaching. To keep those changes from happening, here's what we would do. I like to use Canva to do this, so I'm going to go head over to my Canva account and open up my writing challenge. Now, I've already created these. These are the ones I mentioned are in my Teachers Pay Teachers and my own store. However, what you can do is use a similar format to the one that we already had in our Google Slides presentation. This one happens to be day 6. Choose one of the photos, write 3 to 5 sentences about what's happening. Keep writing if you'd like. They can write more if they'd like. So that will be our slide. After we've got that, maybe I'll take that one, then day 6 and day 7. Good. These look like pages 11, 12, and 13. I'm going to come over here to share, go to download, and choose as a PNG. I'm going to take just the pages that I want, 11, 12, and 13. Boom. Okay, we're going to download those, and then we'll head back over to our Google Slides. Now that we're back in Google Slides, after having downloaded those PNGs, we're going to set them as our background. That way, students won't be able to change them. Here we go. We're going to go to Image, and we can only do this one slide at a time, which is kind of annoying. But we choose slide 11, new slide. We're going to add in our writing slide, 12, and 13. There we go. Looks good. So we've got day 6, a place for them to write, and day 7. Once we have this, you can click around and cannot change anything on here. Great. That's exactly what we wanted. However, they still need to write. So let's go back here. This is the prompt slide. This is the writing slide. All we have to do is click insert, text box, and then make a nice text box here. Depending on the font, maybe you want to set all your fonts so that your students don't have to worry about that or have that choice. And they can start writing here. I want to write about, and then they continue. One of my favorite things about using Google Slides to encourage writing in this way is that we can include creative and different prompts. So you saw before we had these photos that I was able to put in. Then you can also change up the format. For example, I love this one. Finish each sentence and add one more sentence. The forest was alive with the sounds of... They finish that sentence, and then they add one more. Again, we'll add our text box here so that they can do their typing. But it's just one of those things that you can vary the writing styles and formats and outcomes that you want your students or your homeschoolers to work on. Once that's all done, what you'll do is take this in your Google Drive and share it with your students. Perhaps this looks different in a school setting. You might need to grant access in Google Classroom. That's an option. If you're using this in a homeschool setting, here's what I would suggest doing. Show your learners how to access your family's Google Drive. Once they're able to do that, they can then log in themselves and start typing and writing on their own. This is fantastic when you've got multiple kids, like I do, who are working on things simultaneously. I can then check in with them as needed, but also I can then check back and help them revise and edit from my own computer if I'm doing some other work, or I can teach them how to do the editing process on their own. One of the features I love to use in terms of editing is to go back, again, perhaps from another screen, and leave comments. This little plus button with the speech bubble, add comment. I can highlight some text, how about this, and say, let's use a different intro. Then as they go through, they can click resolved, and then you're able to revise and check again for more edits to be made. I hope this was a helpful look at how to keep writing fresh and fun and less work for us as teachers and homeschoolers. If you're interested, remember I do have those 45-day packs in both English and Spanish in my store on my website and also on Teachers Pay Teachers. If you found this helpful, it would be super helpful to me if you would go ahead and like and subscribe to this channel. And if you enjoyed this topic, let me know in the comments. I would love to keep creating more resources like this for you if you're enjoying it. Happy teaching! And if you're a teacher's pay teacher's version. But Melissa.
Scratch that. Scratch all of that.